2, 1.
And now it's time for an exclusive.
You know, the big story in the room, as you know, is this documentary called Quiet on the Set, The Dark Side of Kids TV.
It's
I know
tough.
This is hard.
It's a tough subject, you know, because.
Any accidents on your records?
Not to your knowledge.
Like, I can't really speak on things that I never witnessed. You know what I'm saying? Because all these things happened after I left.
Okay, Keanu, Denzel, welcome to the All That family.
Dad wasn't really on Kenan and Kel like that. Our worlds weren't really like overly, you know, overlapping like that outside of all that.
We're about to introduce our behind the scenes of my man's first movie, Good Burger.
Yeah, you gotta check it out.
Right. It's gonna be a lot of fun. You're gonna enjoy it. Don't go to the bathroom because you might miss something.
Yeah, it's getting huger. Huger.
Because of the growing curiosity of Dan Schneider, I was left wondering what the older children of the 90s went through at Nickelodeon. What I found was shocking.
Being young and being on a TV show, you know what I mean? Being on Nickelodeon was also like a dream come true. It was a lot of fun back then with like the Big Help coming around and Kids' Choice Awards was like pretty newish back then. It was just very exciting times. Like
now, Bill Cosby worked on this movie, and he's also in the movie, so you got to work with him.
You know, he's been performing like all around the country, and he had me meet him up at the Apollo. And I'm sitting up in my little room, and he comes in there, and he's like telling me stories. And then my mom walks in. He's like, "Oh yes, young lady, come sit on my lap."
The girls needed to be protected with so many random people on set; they couldn't just be wandering around by themselves. But the boys. You could just open the door and tell them to come back later.
Oh, over here, come on.
They're like the Heckle and Jekyll of the late 90s.
I do it all.
It's really, really complicated stuff.
What were you like growing up? Were you funny?
I was a class clown, but I got good grades, so I got away with it. And I had like an apple head, and my head was kind of like a melon, so it was like, it was cool. We grew up in the theater. I was, you know, the play of the Gingerbread Man. Don't catch me, I'm Gingerbread Man. You can't catch me. They got eight at the end. Yo, that was me.
What's up?
You would think now, watching these guys on the set, that they've known each other for their entire lives, that they're lifelong boyhood friends. But in fact, they really came together first through all that for Nickelodeon. They invented these characters, Mavis and Clavis, and that was one of their early hits.
After on that, Mavis and Clavis, you're cleared for landing.
You better have some diet soda waiting.
Oh, it's some honey roasted nuts. Yeah. Hit me.
The Kenan and Kel show sort of came about because of the chemistry that those two guys had together.
Here it goes.
The writers and the producers used to watch our chemistry around all that, chemistry. On and off the set. Thanks. I enjoyed that word. Thanks. And then they just, you know, spun off and decided to make a show about it.
About to go deliver some burgers to guess who?
Shaquille O'Neal. He's a good guy. Shaka waka doshu.
Action.
I'm Maria Mitchell. I'm the mother of Kel Mitchell and anyone else who needs a mother.
Oh, I was going to.
That tickles. Ooh, she messed with my ears.
Your hair looks cool.
I left Nickelodeon in 2000, and I was trying to audition for SNL, and they were like, "Nah, you're too young. And a couple years went by, and then Tracy left the show, so there was an opening, and then we just auditioned, like me and a bunch of like other black comedians. And, you know, most black comedians are stand-up, so I had to do stand-up comedy for the first time for the audition. And
but Brian, let's meet your second wife. Brian, this is Hannah, student at Wellington Middle School. But one day, years in the future, she will be your second wife.
When I originally saw this sketch when it aired, I thought it was funny. I now think it's creepy. This is Aria, an artist and musician. She happens to be dating 45-year-old Kenan. She is currently 19. They met as friends on the set of Saturday Night Live. When she was only 15 years old, he showered her in gifts and became her mentor after her appearance. Allegedly.
And together on three.
Together.
One, two, three. Hey.
Nah.
My love of dancing is its own defibrillator. Every time I almost die, I just...
You raggedy bitch.
On a related note, Kel Mitchell can be a future video if you'd like.
My dad wasn't there for me for 10 years.
And how is it like to come back to Nick?
It's great. Fun coming. Good times. Family.
It's tough for me because like I can't really speak on things that I never witnessed. You know what I'm saying? Because all these things happened after I left.
Hey, where'd the panda go?
No way!
Oh, Kenan Thompson!
You're Kenan!
Oh my god!
Because all these things happened after I left.
Oh, hello! I'm Kenan Thompson. I've just been working on this tiny little project here.
I can't really speak on things that I never witnessed. You know what I'm saying? Because all these things happened after I left.
She doesn't want to go out on a date with an old wrinkled fruitcake.
Happened after I left.
If you go back to the very first Nickelodeon show I ever made, that's very evident, as it is in the second one, and then the first movie I ever made for Nickelodeon, which starred Kenan and Kel, and every show I did after that had a lead black actor in it. I'm very proud of that. It's very important to me. And not only am I proud that they were in my shows, I'm exceptionally proud of the achievements they've had beyond my shows, and they've gone on to bigger and better things, and that gives me a great sense of pride.
Millions asked for it, and now Teen Nick is bringing back 90s Nickelodeon. It's the 90s of all that!
Kenan Thompson is rare. Kenan and I have been friends now for 30 years. We met on a show called All That, a show that I am so grateful to have been a part of, that has had such an impact on so many people.
It's hard to put into words what Dan has done for all of us.
What's up, Kids' Choice Awards? When I was asked to be here to present the first ever Nickelodeon Lifetime Achievement Award, I was like, no way, it's not gonna happen. Not unless you can figure out a way for me to be in two places at once, and you did it! So my body is here in New York, but my heart is out there in LA with all of you guys, because I wanna help honor a guy who has spent his entire life making kids laugh. His name is Dan Schneider, and he's the guy behind some of the greatest shows on Nickelodeon. That's why we're honoring him tonight with the special award. So to Dan, I'd like to say thank you. You've made more milk come out of more kids' noses than anybody else. Congratulations.
I know that, like, over the weekend, Dan Schneider, the guy who created All That and Good Burger and all that stuff, he got a Lifetime Achievement Award
at the
Kids' Choice Awards.
Yeah.
Well, I heard that everyone was kind of pissed that Kenan Thompson didn't show up in person. He just made a video.
I don't know. I haven't talked to him in a long time. Just hanging out with Dan, man. That was what it was all about. Just hanging out with Dan, man. That was what it was all about. Just hanging out with Dan, man. That was what it was all about.